Hello guys, welcome to Explore, and this is Vishalakshi. In this video, we are going to talk about electronic configuration, and I am sure that if you watch this video from the beginning to the end, then you can do electronic configuration for any atom very perfectly. So let's go. What is electronic configuration actually? Electronic configuration represents that arrangements of electrons around the nucleus. This is nucleus. And whereas this is K shell, the shell which is very near to the nucleus is known as K shell, and this is L shell, and this is M shell, and the last is N shell, and so on. As to do electronic configuration, you should know about shells, number of electrons accommodated in each shell, subshells, number of orbitals in each subshell, and number of electrons accommodated in each shell. You can understand about all these while doing electronic configuration, but many of the students get confused at this part. First, I am going to give you a brief explanation about electronic configuration using associative learning method so you can understand better and you will never forget it. So our electron is going to join into one of a royal hostel, and it already chose its hostel, and it is around nucleus hostel. I think no one among us dares to join in such a hostel. So its infrastructure is okay, and it has 4 floors. And okay, well, so our electron is going to take an admission. In this hostel, these floors are named as KLMN. So in every hostel, the management will arrange their seat until the first floor fills, they'll never go to second floor. That means our electron is going to get seat in first floor, get room in first floor. That is K shell. So this is the first floor. It has a staff room and library, but only one room is left. So in this hostel, one room can be accommodated by 2 electrons. So first electron and second electron are going to adjust in this room, this 101 room. And this is nothing but 1s, means first and second electron are going to accommodated in 1s subshell. So what about third electron? Third electron should jump to the next floor as to get a room. So let's go to second floor. In the second floor, in this part, only digi hall and labs, and only one room is present. So our third electron and fourth electron can accommodate in this 201 room. That is 2s subshell. So our third electron and fourth electron got room in 201. That is, they are accommodated in 2s subshell, which is present in L shell. There is still some place left in second floor. Let's go to the right part of the room. So there is a hall and 3 rooms left. 202, 203, and 204. So our 5th and 6th electrons got their room in 202, and 7th and 8th in 203, and 9th and 10th in 204. So 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, these 6th electrons got adjusted in these 202, 203, and 204 rooms, and this is called 3p subshell. So these electrons got adjusted in this part of the room, this part of the floor, in their respective rooms. That is, these electrons got seated in this 3p subshell in their respective orbitals in L shell. Same way, the next coming up electrons will jump to their respective subshells, which may or may not be the part of this shell. They may jump to the higher shells. This process continues like this. These are the shells which we consider mostly KLMN, and these are the subshells which we mostly consider as SPDF. So I think now you have got an idea about electronic configuration. Now let's go to the scientific way in which electronic configuration is done. This table gives information about subshell, number of orbitals, and number of electrons accommodated. The order of number of orbitals is nothing but the consecutive odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, And you can find number of electrons accommodated very easily by just multiplying 2 to the number of orbitals. 2 ones are 2 and 3 twos are 6 and it is found here. Let's go for a diagrammatical explanation about how electrons get filled in their respective shells. And now let's consider beryllium, whose atomic number is 4. So it has 4 electrons. So before filling, we should know how many electrons can be accommodated in each shell. So this is K shell and it can accommodate 2 electrons, and this is L shell and it can accommodate 8 electrons, and it is M shell and it can accommodate 16 electrons, and it is N shell and it can accommodate 32 electrons. Now let's go for filling electrons in their respective shells. First, our electrons go to K shell. So but K can accommodate only 2 electrons, so a third electron is going to jump into L shell. So this process continues and electrons keep going on filling like this. This is about shells, but what about subshells? Now let's go for subshells. So as we know, all know, electrons arrange around nucleus in a specific manner, but as to know the order of subshells, we follow Euler's chart. This is Euler's chart. Means electron first go enters into the 1s, then 2s, then 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, and so on. Like this. And I think you got a doubt at 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, but why not 3d? And I'll clarify your doubt when we are doing electronic configuration. There is a reason behind it. Now let's go to the final challenge, electronic configuration. Now let's do it for fluorine, whose atomic number is 9. And we can write its electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2 and 2p5. And this block represents 1s, and this is block represents 2s, and this 3 orbitaled block is 2p. Now let's fill the electrons. Here the second electron went to this block. Why not it entered this block? This is because of Hund's rule. Electron pairing in orbitals starts only when all available empty orbitals of the same energy are singly occupied. That means electrons first get filled in their empty orbitals, and then next they go for refilling, and this is Hund's rule. And hence we completed electronic configuration for fluorine. Now let's take another example. Let's do electronic configuration for calcium, whose atomic number is 20. Let's write electronic configuration. S2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. And why 4s is entering between the 3p and 3d? This is time to clarify your doubt. And it is because of off-bow principle. Orbitals are filled in the order of increasing energy. How we can know the energy of orbitals? There is a formula which gives the answer to this question. Energy is equal to n plus l, where n is principal quantum number and l is angular momentum quantum number. I gave a brief explanation about these quantum numbers in my previous video. Be sure that you watched that video, and if you didn't watch that, I gave a link in the description box. Please watch that also. So for 3D, energy is equal to 3 plus 2 is 5, and for 4s, 4 plus 0 is equal to 4. Here the value of 4s is lesser than the value of 3d, so 4s is written before 3d. Now let's start filling the electrons, and don't forget, here first fill the empty shells, empty subshells, and then go for refilling. And hence we completed the electronic configuration for calcium. And I think now you got an idea about electronic configuration. I completed my explanation and now it's your turn. Do electronic configuration for sodium whose atomic number is 11. Because listening is very different from practicing. If you practice this electronic configuration now, you can get more clarity. And if you have any doubts, please comment me. I'll surely try my best to clarify your doubts. Don't just ignore this. Just keep trying. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.